In this little tutorial, I'm going to talk about how we can use a fractional scale on a map to try to estimate actual distances on land, and not estimate, we're going to calculate those distances. When we look at a fractional scale, this is always a comparison. They're completely unitless scales, and they're really useful because you can plug in any unit you want just using that same fractional scale. The scale that we're going to look at for today will be 1 to, let's say, 10,000. Okay, so this means for every one unit on my map, which is a scaled down version of land, I have 10,000 of the same units on land. So the actual distance is 10,000 times larger. Okay, so a question you might see is someone might say, with this fractional scale, what is, or how many kilometers are represented by, I'm just going to kind of leave this out, how many kilometers are going to be represented by, we'll say, 5 centimeters. Okay, so the first thing that we're going to do, we're given our fractional scale and we're given our starting point. Okay, so that 5 centimeters is actually the 1. So we have to scale it up to find out how many centimeters we have on land. And we do that just by multiplying it by 10,000. So we're just scaling it up. There's no unit on that 10,000. Okay, so now we have 50,000 centimeters. Okay, so now we actually have to convert centimeters into kilometers. So we can do that down below. We now are just going to continue to move this step by step. We have 50,000 centimeters. And to convert this into kilometers, we first have to convert it to meters. Okay? So we have centimeters on the top. I'm just going to set this up, multiplying it by some sort of fraction without panicking about it being a fraction. I'm going to put centimeters on the bottom and meters on the top. Okay? Centi means 100. So there are 100 centimeters for every 1 meter, okay? How do you plug this into your calculator, or how do you do this in your head? You just read it from left to right and down, okay? You don't have to do anything with fractions. You just say 50,000 centimeters times 1 meter divided by 100 centimeters, okay? So this line means divide. So if we do 50,000 centimeters times 1 meter, okay, nothing's changed. We have 50,000 centimeters, 1 meter, divided by 100 centimeters, we're going to get 500 meters. And that's because our centimeters have been canceled, okay? Now we're still not to our final answer. We have to convert 500 meters into kilometers. So we're going to do that the same way. We're going to set it up, multiply it by some unit conversion, and we're going to put meters on the bottom and kilometers on the top. Okay? There are 1,000 meters for every 1 kilometer. Okay? So when we calculate this, 500 meters times 1 kilometer divided by 1,000 meters. Okay, so that's going to be 5 kilometers. Because if we wanted to look at it pretty straightforward, we have 500 meters, it's half of 1,000. So we have 0.5 kilometers as our final distance. And you can use a calculator to double check if you want to make sure. It is really good not to just move decimal places around, because you can accidentally slip it one direction or the other, which would end up giving you the wrong number. And it would actually suggest that your scale was wrong if you were to actually go and try to plot that distance out on land.